It's hard enough these days to pay the grocery bill, let alone buy a new car. And the car industry is definitely feeling the pinch. Forecasters predict it could be the worst year for sales in a decade. But some websites out there are offering new possibilities to would-be buyers and leasers and putting them right in the driver's seat.
With recessionary pressure hurting the household budget, a new car might seem like a luxury. Many consumers are putting the big purchase on hold. Those who can't wait, though, are looking for cheaper options to meet their needs, and they're being rather creative.
I've bought a few vehicles off of eBay Motors, and I think being able to look at the seller's feedback, what other people have bought, what other people have paid for, what they say about the seller, honestly, because they can write whatever they want about a seller.
Patricia Weidler and Dan Whitehead saved about $5,000 when they bought their 2002 Ford truck from eBay. They're a prime example of how people have become comfortable with the idea of buying online. 3 million autos have been sold on the website, which claims a sale is made every 56 seconds.
You want to get the best value for the money that you want to spend, and so not having sales pressure, I can actually look over all of my options, make a nice educated decision, and then purchase what I'm looking for.
If you're not ready to purchase, you can lease as well, and the internet is an option for those looking to get out of a lease or those looking to get in.
It's a 2005 Corvette, automatic, pretty much fully loaded. It's got 27,000 miles on it. It's got T-tops. It's not a rag top. It's a coupe. It's not a convertible. And it's just a nice driver. It's pretty much loaded.
Lease Trader allowed Steve Macchio to take an existing lease off of someone else's hands. He was able to buy up the remaining 27 months of the lease without making the down payment, a savings of $12,000. He pays $535 a month. That may sound like a lot, but the car is worth $50,000.
I went on leasetrader.com, and I was looking for a Corvette, and they have every car under the sun. Anything you want, they have. So as I was scrolling through, I was looking for something that I felt I could afford. I came upon this red Corvette, and before I could talk to the gentleman, I had to do a credit application to make sure that I'm legitimate.
There are some cheaper cars on the site as well for someone who's looking for a daily drive. Lease Trader works directly with financial institutions and pre-qualifies its buyers.
So once they're verified and once they're qualified, they start communicating with sellers. Ultimately, they find the car. So the buyer and the sellers both meet, or they just choose to, move forward with the transaction. And that's where the leasing company takes it from there, and they transfer the contract from one person to the other.
Oh, yeah, it saved a lot of money. Come on, it's 12 grand. I couldn't have done it. I wouldn't have been able to do that.
A ride in style Macchio wouldn't have otherwise been driving.
While leasing is good for consumers who want a car for the short term, buying a car generally makes more financial sense. But it's important to finance correctly. Edmunds.com recommends putting down 20% and taking a five-year loan term. Now, some new autos are being financed for up to 84 months or 7 years. So avoid this if you can, or you'll find yourself owing more on the loan than the car is actually worth. Now, for those leasing, keep the terms to 3 years or less. And one more thing. The couple we told you about who bought on eBay, they made the 3 millionth purchase. So in honor of that milestone, eBay actually picked up the tab.